Lord, thank you for your word. We hear it. We receive it. We believe it. That we may be a doer of it. You increase. We decrease. We give you praise, Father. Honor and glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. You never know when God is going to move in your life. You never know when the day come and it's the day of your breakthrough. Amen. You never know when you wake up one morning that it's the day that an answer to your prayers is going to happen. You never know when you meet someone how it's a connection to your destiny. You never know when you come to a meeting, if it's not the time that the power of God will touch you and heal you or set you free or fill you. You never know when you go to your regular work, if it's not the day that you will have a divine encounter. You never know when you meet and you talk to even people who you think you know in the natural, that God might use them to tell you something. You never know. The Lord wants you to know that you never know. It's important to him. He said, tell them they never know. I said, what do you mean? He said, they never know. And they never can think they know, because otherwise they can not grab a hold of what I do when I do it. They don't know. When Jesus answers prayers, he delights in doing it in a way that you don't know. Even when you know that he's going to answer prayers, you never really know how he's going to do it. And if you think he's going to do it one way, he will surprise you and do it another way, because he doesn't want you to know. Because if you know, you will depend and trust what you know instead of who you know. He doesn't want you to forget who he is. He doesn't want you to trust in what you know. He wants you to know that as long as he knows, even if you don't know, it doesn't matter. As long as you know that he knows, because he knows you and you know him. Hallelujah. Don't ask me to repeat that. I don't know. There's a wind that's happening right now. And it's a wind that is blowing across the land where the Holy Spirit is bringing forth some of the answers to our prayers in unexpected ways. When Abraham sent Elijah to find a wife for Isaac, you know the story, he put inside the camels all the wealth of Abraham was inside the camel. When Rebecca went to get water on a regular day. She didn't know. She didn't know that the old man that asked her to give drink to the camels was connected to a rich, handsome Isaac. She didn't know. She didn't know that the very camels she was giving water to were filled with wealth. She didn't know. See, sometimes we have the tendency to walk by sight and not by faith. And we have the tendency to determine how God is going to answer a prayer based on what we can see. But in this season, it's very important because I'm telling you, God is moving right now and is about to bring to you some things that might be packaged away that doesn't look like what you're expecting. But as you obey and you're faithful in what God's calling you to do, at what He's telling you to be, that you never know if an old man that you're helping might not be connected to your future beautiful, handsome husband. You never know. If one day you can help an older lady across the street and she leaves you her whole inheritance. You never know. The Bible is clear about being no respecter of person. It talks in James, if you see someone that's dressed very nice and you give him the best seat in the front, right? It's in James somewhere. He said, God is no respecter of person. Says, never give the best seat to whoever appears to deserve it, because somebody might be dressed up with a three-piece suit to cover dirt that you do not see. Why? Because you never know. You never know. Don't treat someone who looks a certain way better than someone who doesn't look that same way. Because you never know. Oh God. You never know if you might be at your job or somewhere and somebody walks in with a pair of jeans and you don't know, it might be the CEO of the company, because you never know. I know wealthy people who don't dress like they're wealthy. And I know people who dress like they're wealthy and they broke. Because you never know. You never know, and you never can think you know. And even if you know a certain way about someone, you don't see the changes that might have happened. So even what you knew, you cannot know. That's why it's so challenging between couples and people who know each other to receive the things of the kingdom, to look at each other spiritually, because if you married to someone, you think you know. But you never know.
You can't assume.
Because if you believe in transforming glory, you don't know. Right? You never know. I think about all the stories in the Bible where you see God answers prayers even when Elijah meets the widow that was going to kill herself and the boys. But she meets Elijah, so she takes the time to be nice. So, you know, lately I see some people are just not nice. And I'm thinking, you never know. You never know who you're being mean to. And you never know you, children of God, as you stand strong in the character of Christ that you're manifesting everywhere, you never know. As you walk nice, you never know. Elijah meets her and she's nice to him. And he's the key to her survival. He's the key. Not just for her making ends meet and not killing her children, but even the key to her future. Just because she runs into one person who asks her one question, and instead of being so locked in her own situation, in her own problems, in her own shares, in her own life, she takes the time to get out of her own misery and ask question and answer what's asked. Why? Because you never know. Right? You just never know. You go to church like tonight. And you think you know what's going to happen. But truly, you never know. Why? There's a passage in Matthew or in Mark. I just want to show you. You just never know. Whew! I feel the Holy Spirit. Because you never know. Right? Do you guys know? No. Because you never know. But in Luke chapter 19, look in Luke chapter 19. We read in verse 1, it says, then Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. And now behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus who was a chief tax collector. And he was rich and he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not because of the crowd. For he was of short stature. So he ran ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was going to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must stay at your house. You never know. You never know. If you then make a left, look at another. Ooh, I feel the Spirit of the Lord. He wants us to kind of look when Jesus passed by. You never know when Jesus is going to show up. Amen. It's so powerful. In Mark, my God, in Mark chapter 6, in verse 45, we read, immediately, he made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, to Bethsaida, while he sent the multitude away. And when he had sent them away, he departed to the mountain to pray. And now, when the evening came, the boat was in the middle of the sea, and he was alone on the land. And then he saw them straining and rowing, for the wind was against them. Now, about the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea and would have passed them by. And when they saw him walking on the sea, they supposed it was a ghost and cried out, for they all saw him and were troubled. But immediately he talked with them and said to them, "Be of good cheer, it is I, do not be afraid." And then he went up into the boat to them, and the wind ceased, and they were greatly amazed in themselves beyond measure and marveled, for they had not understood about the loaves, because their heart was hardened. Because you never know, even when you think it's a ghost, it's the Lord. They could have stopped and totally freak out because they thought it was a ghost, and look at the storm and panic. See, sometimes the way that God brings you an answer is not the way that you would look at something and know the answer is there in front of you. God loves to cause you to be moved by faith. He looks to see if instead of looking at what you can see, you would look for him in every situation, because your faith is in him regarding of what you see. So he sees if even though something looks frightening, like it's a ghost, and even though there's a storm, or even though there's such a big crowd like Zacharias, and there's no way that Jesus could even reach him because he was so short. See, I'm kind of tall. You better be quiet. But I know what it is to be in a situation that I had so many people in front of me that I couldn't see anything. That I would go to meetings and I would surely think, well, nobody's going to see me. And the Lord, he would have somebody see me because Jesus could see me. Jesus would have somebody come to me and talk to me where I was, even though I was shorter. Because Jesus knows, even though I don't know. Because even though sometimes we tempted to be confident and dependent and have confidence in what we know, Jesus always treasures our faith for us to be able to see that at every turn in our life, we never know what God is about to, but we know that he's about to do something great, because he can't help himself. God never does something little. He always brings you the best. He always reaches you in every circumstances. God knows how to just see you. He knows how in the middle of the storm, even though he saw them straining through the storm, he waited until 3 o'clock in the morning. Really, Jesus? Your clock must be broken. Really? 3 a.m. Come on. They've been straining for hours. Why? Why 3 a.m.? Wait, I don't know about you, but I ask questions like this to the Lord. I read stories like that, and I'm like, whoo, 3 a.m., because I know this God, that you never know according to his time when his 11:59 is. You never know. How would you know? Right now, it's 8 o'clock. It's 8 o'clock here. But it's 4 o'clock in the morning in Paris. Probably should be asleep by now. And another part of the world, it's another time. So when Jesus, he said, no, your prayer is going to be answered, you really don't know when. Have you ever waited on God for something specific and you didn't know? But now the Holy Spirit is stretching you, and instead of you not knowing and waiting and wondering, now what he wants us to do in this season is not wonder, and it's more than expecting, it's being able to see through the circumstances, through the people around us, and expect God to use everyone and everything. The people you know, the people you don't know, your regular day, your regular night. He wants you to be so expecting to see him in the midst of everything that you will have no fear, because as long as you belong to him, you can always hear in your spirit, it is I. Do not be afraid. It is I who works into all circumstances. It is I who takes care of things that pertains to you. It is I who know exactly how to make the wind blow your way. You will not hear, you will not know how it's happening, but you will see the wind is around you because of the way I will move things around for you. The Lord, He's got a sense of humor. He answers prayers. You know, last week, I think last Sunday or the day before, he said, this is the season of answered prayers. Wow. 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 And I said, wow. And I started trying to think of some of your prayers. And I said, well, Lord, what prayers? Can you give me some input? Whose prayers are being answered? What are you doing? And he said, you never know. Just know that this is the season, he said, that my people who have prayed from their heart according to my will, said it shall be done. It shall be done. So you know, there's expecting answers. For example, you're looking for a job. Everybody knows, so I'm not saying any secret. When you look for a job, you would be expecting the job to come when you go to an interview. Right? But you never know. You never know. You could have someone that comes to you in need of prayer, and the natural tendency, you know, is to be tired and been looking for a job for 3 weeks. Why is this lady coming to me for prayer again? I prayed for her last week for the same thing. Here she is. She doesn't do that. I'm giving an example. I'm showing you that the moment that you stretch yourself, you never know if the person that you put ahead of your need is not a connection to an answer to your prayer, that person would have an opening in a job. I remember getting a job. I remember getting a job at a real estate company, an accounting job, and all I did was talk to that lady on another printing job at the same printing company, and all I did was talk to her about me thinking of getting on the radio for the ministry when I first started. That's all I did. And then the week after, she said, well, you know, you said you were looking for extra income. I heard about this and I thought of you. And I thought, wow, you never know. I thought you never know. When I was looking to have the visas to come back here in this country after I had been deported, the people had said that I couldn't come back until a certain time, that they wouldn't have any visas available. And one day I'm on my little bicycle going to get the French bread. On my bicycle. And I get this incredible urge in my spirit to call Paris. But in order to call Paris, I needed to use the bread money. So I had a choice. Use the bread money, obey what I was hearing to call Paris to see if they had the visas to come here, or get the bread. If I used the bread money and the call was negative, I would go home and be in beaucoup trouble. Right? But it was so strong, and you're thinking, call Paris for what? It makes no sense, because in the natural, I'm not supposed to. Because they said there wouldn't be any visa. But when God answers a prayer, you never know. You never know. You learn to follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. You don't need to know. All we need to do is obey. Because with every step of obedience, there's a greater walk into your future. And I called, and the lady said, well, how did you know? I said, what do you mean? She said, we have three visas that came up just yesterday. If you can come get them within a week, you can have them. Wow. I went home with no bread. But I had a smile on my face. I couldn't understand what had just happened. I just walked in and went straight to my grandma and said, guess what happened? But when I went on my bicycle to go get the bread, I didn't know. But I had to pay attention to that small, still voice when it came. Because you never know. You never know. What is it in your life right now, tonight, that the Holy Spirit is using this word to really sharpening our senses, to really for us not to take it for granted when we meet people, when we, you know, don't belittle anything that comes your way in this season. This is a season of obedience. This is a season of obedience. This is a season of answered prayers. With every answered prayers, God will lead you to take another step of obedience. God won't answer your prayer and not ask you to do something. Why? Because with every answered prayer, there's an increase of faith. When God answers your prayers, your faith rises up. And when your faith rises up, you can take another step of obedience like never before. He wants to keep you excited in this season. A job could come to you that you don't apply for. I tell single people, you don't have to go somewhere for your mate to find you if you're a woman, or for a man to go somewhere to find. No, no, you're just obedient right where you are. Because this God that we serve is into divine alignment. He sees you where you are, and he aligns this person and that circumstance and that thing. He brings to you what he has for you. I can't wait until I meet Rebecca to see how she reacted when suddenly she realized that the very camel she was giving water to were carrying such wealth. Or when finally Eliza just introduced her to Isaac. Can you believe? When I used to work restaurants, there were some people that they only wanted to wait on the people that looked like they had money. No, it's true. So they were always trying to pass tables because they wanted the big tips. And I didn't really care because I thought, God's going to provide for whatever he has for me. And one day, I got a $100 tip with one penny. One penny, when you wait tables, means bravo, above and beyond. Yeah, if you go eat somewhere and you have excellent service, don't just leave the penny. The penny was on the top of the 100, you understand? It means excellent service. But that person looked really poor. This person wasn't really nice when you waited on him. But every time I would go to his table, I was smiling, filled with joy. I was who I was regardless of who he was. You don't let the light shine just if somebody tell you you can. Actually, the greater the darkness, the greater you should shine. And you don't portray the character of Christ just when you come to church. Because you never know. You might be working in a company and somebody from the church come and you're there having an attitude, yelling at everybody. Because you never know. And you come to church the Sunday after and somebody says, is that you? I heard you. I went to the public service and I heard somebody yell and I looked and it was you. Because you never know. You never know when you leave a church and you go to your car with your mate and you mean with your mate. You start complaining. 15 minutes before, you were a deacon. Church, sitting people with a big smile, then you go to your car and you talk to your wife like, you never know who is listening. Because the same way that God will bring to you for answer prayer when he sees that you walk and you represent his character, the same way when he knows, I couldn't do the message without telling you that part. But when he knows the opposite, when he knows you one way as a deacon,
it's true. If you were mean with Thomasine, well, first of all, she probably would go home. She wouldn't be here. But she probably would be thinking, I can't believe how nice you are with people. And you talk to me like that. That would give her a misrepresentation of who your God is, wouldn't it? So when God, when he sees, then you never know how he will bring you to a place so that you can see that everything that's hidden. Comes to light. Why? Because he wants to stretch you. He wants to stretch you. You never know. If you're looking for a wife and you're looking for just somebody that looks beautiful, well, you never know. I remember this man telling me, guess what happened? I said, what? He said, oh, I met this beautiful woman and we went in a hotel room. Is there kids here? I can't see a thing. Yeah. Huh? Oh, okay. So let's find another example. Let's just say that if you take somebody in a hotel room and they go in the bathroom to change and come out, let's just say you never know. I leave it at that. Moving along. Woo! Got really hot in here. Never know what Dr. J is going to say. But you never know. We children of God, we shouldn't walk by sight, ever. We should know no man according to the flesh. And the same way, with the same message, you can't never assume based on what somebody said or based on what you saw. You have to look for the heart of people. You never know. You can't never assume either. Hallelujah. I remember buying some cigarettes for my daughter at a Safeway, and and of course I'm there in the aisle going to the cash register with a pack of cigarettes right there, and somebody from the church. Happens to go to King Su to Safeway that day. You never know. Have you ever run somebody from the church in a store and you're thinking, I didn't know they came here? Because you never know, right? And she looks at the cigarettes. And I know she wants to ask and she's thinking, assuming that I smoke. And the Holy Spirit said, don't say nothing. So I didn't say anything. I just say, hi, how you doing? How's it? And I'm right there in the cigarettes. Well, next thing you know, the whole church talks about me smoking. Another day, you remember in the old church, when it's a holiday, I have real wine and I have grape juice and I have a sign, of course, people can take whatever based on. But that day, like many days, I really get drunk of the Holy Spirit. So it's the end of the night, and in the foyer of the church, I'm sitting on a chair. And there's the bottle, the leftover wine, right there. And I'm really drunk of the Holy Spirit, so I'm really, you know, like drunk. And this lady, well, and she's so shocked. Her whole face, she's like. And I'm so drunk, I'm like. Because I'm so drunk, I see no evil in a way. That I'm not even thinking, you understand? That people who critique and look, they will find. But I'm so drunk that I'm not even thinking what she may be thinking. At that point, I don't even remember there's the wine there. Well, for months, people were talking about the pastor drinking wine. So you never know. You never know what people would think based on what they see, right? But we cannot be like that. We cannot assume. We cannot jump to conclusion. That's the worst exercise anybody can do. We cannot just think that we heard one thing or know one thing. We don't know. You never know. You don't walk into a room and be in the middle of a conversation when you haven't heard all the pieces. You never know really what's behind the story of a story when people tell you they want you to pray for this and that. You never know really what's at the bottom of things. You never know what only God knows that goes on behind closed doors. You never know. You never go by what looks one way. You don't know. No, it's not because somebody drives a nice car that it's paid for. Amen. They could be broke. I remember marrying some people and then they found out they both were broke. I said, well, you know, and if you come to me for premarital counseling, I probably will have you pull out some credit report first to make sure. That's usually what I do. I talk about money, sex, and children. That's premarital counseling, not necessarily in that order. Because they just assumed that the other person was wealthy. Because of the car, because of the house, because of clothes. You don't walk by sight. You'll marry with someone with more debt than you can count. You don't know if the person just went to put everything on credit. Then they marry you and give you the debt. Because when you marry them, you partake the debt. Hallelujah. I don't know who I said that for, but I just... So the bottom line is, you catch my drift? The Lord is telling us, you never know. You never know. But you can trust him. Don't go by what you see. And know that in this season, because of a season of answered prayers, everything that's in the dark, just take it to him. You take it to his light and let him help you. Amen. You don't want something to just boom, schlag, you know. You want the good schlag. You don't want the bad schlag. But you people of God, you don't have to be concerned about that because you're faithful, because you're gonna get the job, you're gonna get the accounts, you're gonna get the money. You're going to go see another Bronco game soon? That I know. You got the thing is on the way. The other thing is on the way. That thing is already done. That thing is done. Amen? What if you meet the grandfather of your husband and he's an old guy? You never know, right? Right? So stand to your feet. want to release that anointing upon you? What if tonight in prayer is the night that you receive your healing? You never know. What if it's the night that you set free? You never know. What if it's the night that the power of the Holy Ghost come upon you and zap, zip, zoop, schlack you? You never know. What if it's the night that the Lord has such a powerful word for you that it takes your destiny to your future? What if it's the night that a brother or sister in the church that never talks to you is used by God to tell you something that will change the purpose of your future? What if we really, according to the Bible, can entertain angels unaware, not knowing that they are angels that God sends us? Hallelujah. You never know. The person's not going to say, I'm an angel. Raise up your expectation. Tonight, as you lift up your hands, let it be like you're lifting up your antennas, your spiritual antennas, like beam, whatever. I'm trying to think of the science fiction stuff. Beam me up, Scotty. Who said that?
Star Trek.
Well, beam us up, Jesus. Say, beam us up, Jesus. Lift up our spiritual antennas. We will move by the Spirit. We will see by the Spirit. Hear in the Spirit. We will not walk by sight, but by faith. We never know, but we know you, and you know us. So we expect the unexpected at any time of any day. Thank you, Lord. Answer our prayers as you have spoken. We receive it that you may be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah.